Hello, I'm Guy Sweeting at the Australian Bureau of Statistics. The ABS, which has collected the CPI since 1960, is committed to producing high-quality official statistics and regularly undertakes reviews to ensure that data is relevant and up-to-date. The ABS has undertaken a project to update the way that the Consumer Price Index, the CPI, is calculated. I spoke with Bruce Hockman, the Chief Economist at the ABS, about the ABS new project, Enhance the Australian CPI. And I asked him whether it remains relevant to today's contemporary information environment.
Well, first of all, Bruce, what are the changes being made to the CPI?
Well, the three major changes we're making are the introduction of the 17th series of CPI, which we do every 6 years. We reweight the CPI using information we get from the Household Expenditure Survey. We will also be switching to annual reweighting of the CPI instead of waiting for that Household Expenditure Survey every 6 years. We can use the data we get in the National Accounts for Household Final Consumption Expenditure to recalculate the weights, and we're making greater use of transactions data that we now have access to as well.
When will the changes be made to the CPI?
Well, the first set of those changes will actually happen with the December quarter release, which is happening on the 31st of January next year. But the annual reweighting, the first year where we'll do the annual reweights, will actually be with the release of the December quarter 2018, which means in early 2019.
Why are the changes necessary?
One of the reasons for making the changes is that we actually want to keep the data contemporary, and the changes in spending patterns need to be reflected in the CPI.
What is the ABS doing to keep the CPI contemporary?
Incorporating the latest weights that we have for people's spending patterns is certainly a big part of that. That's probably the greatest thing. We are able to now use transactions data more directly, and we're introducing that into the CPI to a greater extent than we have in the past. We also have, for some prices, we're now conducting web scraping, which is where you actually go to somebody's website, see what prices are being charged, and the technology allows us to do that pretty well automatically and as often as we like. So we can measure the average price over, say, a whole month and incorporate that then into our quarterly estimates.
Let's talk about some of the processes involved in the CPI. Regular sample maintenance, what is that?
Well, essentially what we have is a rolling program where we're making sure that we keep the CPI relevant and up to date and reflect people's actual purchasing patterns. One of the things that we can incorporate at the lower level of the lower than publication level by through our regular sample maintenance is actually to bring in new products as well as changing spending patterns.
And a lot of those processes of keeping it contemporary involves people that now use apps to do online shopping and things like that, so the CPI has to keep up with that.
Yeah, we have to. Basically, we have enough information now to bring in the new products much quicker into our measurements and therefore, again, keep the CPI up to date with what people are actually doing.
Thank you very much, Bruce, for answering our questions today about the changes coming up to the CPI.
Well, I hope that you found details of our Enhance the Australian CPI of interest. The ABS is committed to working to ensure that we continue to deliver relevant, trusted, and objective statistics. If you'd like to find out more about Enhance the Australian CPI, please go to the ABS website.